This is Bryony after just seeing Little Women. I cried a lot and I loved it.
I have no idea what was real. What was fantasy or like in people's heads? That ending, holy shit. Holy shit, okay. Fuck. Wow.
So I just finished Before Midnight and those last, what, 40 minutes? That was the most real fight I've ever seen in film. I loved that one. Actually, no, I'd have to say the first one's my favourite. Could have been a standalone, but I'm glad they added the two. The first one's my favourite, then third, then second.
So what did you think?
I really liked it.
I'll get it.
I thought it was cool. What, speechless? What a bop. Loved it.
Naomi Scott played the same character that she did in Lemonade Mouth. Now that's not a criticism because Lemonade Mouth is gorgeous. But never, and I mean never, put dance routines, perfectly choreographed musical theatre dance routines, never put them in fast forward. Even the tiniest bit. God. God, it annoyed me. Never. Don't do it. Don't do it. Just don't.
We just finished. What's it called? House of Flying Daggers in film. I enjoyed it.
So did I.
For the last half an hour, I had my mouth open. It was full of twists and turns. Wasn't expecting it. It was fun. It was very pretty as well.
You Were Never Really Here was shocking and moving. My favourite sequence was the CTV sequence. He's a really artistic director and I really like his use of colour. I feel his views on gender are slightly outdated. Like, they're like a couple years behind. But that might just be a cultural thing. I do not know.
Dude. Believe the hype about the half of it.
I can already tell after first watching that this film is going to mean a lot to me. It's intelligent and beautiful.
Soundtrack was nice, atmosphere, very nice. Just writing, I don't know whether they were trying to make fun of the like LA linguistics and cliches of that, but I don't know if they were, I don't know whether it worked, and if they weren't, then it was just cliche and a bit annoying. But yeah, I enjoyed it.
I watched Frozen 2 and I fucking loved it, in my opinion, and I think it was better than the first one. It was very predictable because I did guess the ending. Kristoff. Absolute banger. The deaths were not impactful enough. When Anna was singing about grief, I was like, oh wait, Elsa's dead. But no, she's not dead. She's just frozen.
I just watched my first ever Studio Ghibli film, Kiki's Delivery Service. And oh my god, the cutest thing in the world. Oh, it's such a feel-good film. I just smiled the whole time. It's so cute. I want to live inside this film. I want to live in this film. I want to live in that old lady's house. That was really pretty. Very nice. And I've got to agree with her granddaughter, though. I'm not eating a fish and pumpkin pie. It's not happening. It's not happening.
I watched Totoro with my brother. I enjoyed it very much. I think all Studio Ghibli films are stunning. They're absolutely stunning, and that is what I watch them for. I watch them for the visuals. Like, they're so touching and heartwarming stories. Like, they're beautiful stories, but the imagery is what people go there for. The art.
Room. Very good. I love Brie Larson. I love Brie Larson a lot.
I cried and almost had a panic attack, but I didn't, so, you know, that's good. I'm going to watch Charlie and Lou now, so I don't have bad dreams.
The vibes, immaculate. Just the right amount of chaos.
I read the book yesterday and I watched the film today. I'm not sure whether me reading the book first damaged or enhanced my experience with the film. I thought it was a good film, but a bad adaptation. I feel like in some ways the film romanticised his mental illness and in other ways the book did. So they're both as bad as each other. There wasn't enough emotional weight.
Midsummer, I'm so excited. It's on Prime, I didn't even realise.
Oh. My. God. First thing I want to say is I fucking love you, Florence Pugh. I really don't know what to say. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You know? You get. Do you. You understand?
That was cute. That was a really cute film. The characters were a little bit stereotypical, but I think I can get over that. Because it was cute.
And by. Like, I think, yeah.
Oh, if you can't tell, I have been crying.
Did he really want this film to be made about him? Did he really want? He says, I don't want to be a sub story. But what is this film other than a sub story? You know what I mean? But then at the end, made quite clear that he did consent, I guess. I cried a lot. I cried a lot, but I don't think I'll watch it again. I still don't think I liked it that much. It did what it was meant to do, like it made me cry. But I'm still like, I don't know how I feel about it, you know. I just want to say that I'm very attracted to Dev Patel. That is not an intellectual response to this film, but it is truth nonetheless. It's incredibly heartwarming and I enjoyed every second of it. Yes, I would say so. The way that I wish more historical dramas were blind casted, because the colour in this film.
Can you hear that I cried? 'Twas sad. 'Twas sad. 'Twas happy. 'Twas funny. I mean, 'twas quite predictable. But that still didn't take away from the impact of the emotional reveal, because I did cry multiple times.
There were some questionable choices in this film. Questionable not only by the casting of James Corden. Some of it just didn't fit, right? Like, the cinematography was off, it was just a bit... Where are the choices? Where are the correct choices? Because I'm not seeing them. However, if you know me, you know that I have a thing for colour. And especially colour symbolism and colour association in film. In this, it's like, the more colourful you are, the more yourself you are, the more accepting you are. And this can be seen in the costumes, this can be seen in the lighting. I enjoyed it very much.
I cannot make speeches, Emma. If I loved you less, I might be able to talk about it more. Oh, some of the camera movements. Oh, especially in haberdashery. The way that it lingers and moves with Emma, and the way that it lingers and moves with Harriet, and the way that it lingers and moves with Mr. Martin. Oh, I fucking love it! I thought this would be better.
Okay, and what was the point in making you Prince the fucking historical reenactor? Like,
It feels like it wasn't. You know what? This feels like a group project, and everyone had different ideas, and they were like, "Let's just combine them all."
Let's do them all. Yeah. I hope everyone is good, and hopefully we can do another movie night soon or something.
Yeah,
definitely.
I'll see you guys soon.
Love you. Bye. Bye-bye.
I don't know how to leave. How do you leave?
At the top.
Oh, top corner.
X.